हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट, एज यू ऑल नो, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द लेक्चर्स फॉर न्यूमेरिकल रिवीजन। यू हैव ऑलरेडी अटेंडेड so far 4 lectures of revision, in which we have solved various types of numericals, and accordingly you were sent your homework also. This PDF, this assignmental PDF is made just for your particular comfort, understand, because this PDF involves examples from your textbook as well as some of the examples from reference book also, for more and more practice, understand. Now dear student, our lecture number 4, we were solving those examples where you have been given the verbal data and you were translating the data in presentation of figure, and then you were solving the example. But in today's lecture number 5, you will have the circuit already in front of you, and you have to find equivalent resistance. Okay, so today in lecture number 5, be little more conscious how to deal with the particular type of circuit, because electric circuit may involve some junction point which is actually called a wire joint, understand. See dear student, chapter number 12, as you all know, that's the chapter of electricity. Okay, and this is lecture number 5 for revision of numericals, right? Lecture number 5. Understand, I am writing revision just for the sake of separating it from the regular lecture. Otherwise, we are taking the numericals for the first time, okay? But just to separate from the regular lecture, sometime if some lecture are broadcasted, rebroadcasted, so that at that time you will understand it easily, right? Now see dear student, today first we are starting from your worksheet number 27, okay? You already have PDF, and some of the students might have also got its physical copy ready. Understood? Now, first read the question either from PDF or worksheet physical copy you have. What is number 27C? Find the equivalent resistance in the following CKT circuit between points A and B. Also find the current flowing in the circuit. See dear student, first the question where you have to find equivalent resistance across points A and B at the same time you also have to find the current flowing in the circuit. The very first thing, we will first draw circuit diagram which is given here to understand it more proper. Okay, 2 points. Point A and point B. Okay, no doubt you already have PDF or worksheet, but when I am explaining, you should also draw with me. Okay, here they have shown battery already, that is of 10 volt. Okay, battery is of 10 volt. Then the first resistor here, that's R1. Okay, R1 equals to 5 ohm. Then here, dear student, a solid wire joint, one resistor here. You draw with me. Okay, now let us join this. This is resistor R4, that is 10 ohm has been given. Now the one resistor continue from here. Okay, this is called R2. That's equal to 5 ohm again, and one more resistor here they have shown, R3. Okay, this is looking the complete circuit. R3 has been given 5 ohm. First, dear student, you first need to understand the diagram. How to start? Understand, that's very, very important for all of us. How can you start this? See, dear student, what is my personal guidance is, whenever you are asked to find equivalent resistance between any 2 point, here you are looking for the equivalent resistance between point A and B. Do not start from the resistor in combination nearer to this point, but start thinking from the combination of resistor away from points A and B. So, dear student, our first target, I am just highlighting this, our first target will remain this part. These two resistors, just try to understand what I am explaining you. Our first target is these two resistors. Forget about the rest. Now try to understand. Here is wire joint, here is wire joint, but here there is no wire joint. It is a constant wire. So both the resistor R2 and R3 are in series connection. You see, dear student, they are in series connection. So let us find equivalent resistance of R2 and R3, and I will call it R5. Okay. So we are starting from here. Concentrate, dear student, because I am going to reduce the figure section wise as we move. Okay. First, no wire joint. Constant wire without any joint, that means the series connection. Let me write the first statement. Let R5 be, please note down, be equivalent resistance of R2 and R3. Okay. Obviously, in series connection, you can write connected in series. Why series? I told you, no wire joint, constant. That means series connection. So should I write the formula? What is that? R5 equal to R2 plus R3. Okay. Let me write the value 5 plus 5. What is that? 10 ohm. So R5 is the equivalent resistance of R2 and R3. So now the circuit is reduced. I am going to remove this section of the circuit, dear student. Just try to understand this, because two resistors just converted into one resistor, and I also want to highlight it in this way. Now I am just writing here, see dear student, only one resistor I am showing. Understood? And that is actually resistor R5. Try to understand. The circuit has been reduced. R5 equal to 10 ohm. Now let us move further, dear student. Now target these two resistors, R4 and R5, wire joint, understands? And as you can see, both are looking in, and in fact they are in parallel connection. So let me take its equivalent resistance as R6. So I am writing it now here. Okay, please concentrate. Let R6 be equivalent resistance of R4 and R5 in parallel. Okay, right? So let me take the formula. 1/R6 equal to 1/R5 plus 1/R4. Substitute the value. 1/10 plus 1/10, 2/10, 1/5, reciprocalize, R6 equal to 5 ohm, which is equivalent resistance of R4 and R5. So circuit is now reduced. Try to understand, dear student, very important fact. Now the circuit has been reduced to only this part. Understand? And I will show R6 here. This is R6, which is equal to 5 ohm. Now you understood? Circuit is going on. Now no wire joint, both are in series connection. So now we do not, because it is the last stage, so now I will take equivalent resistance of R1 and R6 as R. So I am writing the third statement, let R be equivalent resistance of R1 and R6 in series. So my formula for series, R equals to R1 plus R6, R1 that is 5, R6 that is 5, 10 ohm. So we got the equivalent resistance R 10 ohm. And now let us find the current flowing in the circuit. What you will write? As per Ohm's law, you will write V equals to IR, V10, I we have to find R10, you will get I equal to 1 ampere. See the sum, dear student. See the steps involved. This way you can go on reducing the circuit. First stage, we found R5, then we found R6, then you found R, and then you found equivalent resistance. This is called the topic of reducing the circuit and finding equivalent resistance. Okay, is it clear in your mind? I have gone just in this particular example, I have gone on reducing the circuit one by one. Understand? Is it clear in your mind? Now, dear student, the next example, that is example number 28. In that particular example, I will just draw the circuit for you here. Then I will give you 5 minutes or 2-3 minutes time to solve itself by yourself. Okay? Then we will definitely do it here on the board, and then you just have to analyze how you have solved. Understand? Let me draw the circuit for you, okay? You have already received PDF, understand? Right. So, number 28 we are targeting now, understood? Number 28. I'm just going to draw the circuit diagram for you, and rest of the process to be completed by you. And I will just give 2-3 minutes time also. So what type of circuit is looking like? Let us see that. What is the question? Determine the equivalent resistance in the following circuit between points A and point C, and point B, sorry, A. And here they have given point B. Understood? between these two already one resistor okay and two resistor they have solved here also one resistor one more resistor here also they have shown two resistors and one more resistor here in this way okay what they have called R1 R2 okay R1 R2 understood then R3 R4 R5 all resistors are equal of 3 ohm all resistor are of 3 ohm okay and you are looking for finding the equivalent resistance between points A and B I am giving you here 3 3 3 this is 6 ohm dear only the one resistor is different okay now please concentrate I am giving you 2 minutes time 2 to 3 in that time try to complete and as I told you your attention has to remain on the two points which are required please try this out just in 2 to 3 minutes you have to concentrate on the junction point that's very important ध्यान क्या आपवानु junction point upar usi par you need to be very attentive points A and points B that is your main attention points understand wherever there are no joints that's called a series connection understand just try this out in 2 to 3 minutes time you can do it just concentrate you can do it it's not so difficult example understood but such circuit are actually those student who are not concentrating may cause problem for them those student who are hearing word to word that no junction point constant wire that means it ensures that it is series connection understand just 1 minute now dear student and then we will complete the example here and you just have to verify with your example which you have already calculated is it clear make it little fast so that we can solve more examples understood right can we do now I want the statements okay dear student you must have started from here somebody may have started from here no problem at all these two wire joint are here this is not a wire joint it is constant wire so R1 and R2 are in series connection their equivalent resistance if I take R6 here I take R7, okay, let me write the statement let. What you will write? Let R6 be total. Sometime you can also utilize the word total resistance of which two we are targeting first, of R1 and R2 in series. Okay. So what you will write? R6 equal to R1 plus R2, that's 3 plus 3 equal to 6 ohm. Is it clear? Now, you must have targeted these two resistors where also no wire joint exists, it is constant wire. So, you may have written a statement like this, let R7 be total resistance of R3 and R4. Okay. Let R7 be total resistance of R3 and R4. Let me take the formula of series, dear student. R7 equal to R3 plus R4, again 3 plus 3, 6 ohm. Now you understood one very important point. The circuit has been reduced. I am not erasing this, but I am just showing it. These two resistor has now become this. This I may call R6. These two has been reduced. And I am calling it R7. Now, can you guess now? If you just erase it out, then these three resistors are in parallel connection, R5, R6 and R7. So, now the last step of the sum. So, let me take R. So, I will write, let R be total resistance of R5, R6 and R7 in parallel. So let me write the formula, 1 upon R5, 1 upon R6, 1 upon R7, 1 upon 6 plus 1 upon 6 plus 1 upon 6, 3 upon 6 cancelled, 1 upon 2 reciprocalize. You got the equivalent resistance as 2 ohm. Check the sum, dear student. And just verify with the example you have already solved. If you have started from here, no problem at all. Then you jump to this section, understand, it's all okay. You suppose you have called, some student may call R double dash, no problem at all. But your logic and your understanding needs to be extremely clear regarding series and parallel connection. You understood this. Is it clear in your mind? Okay. So this is actually example number 28. Okay. Now, dear student, let us target example number 29. I'm just no need to give you time to draw because you must have done it in your book, but those students who could not solve this, please concentrate and write it down. Then I will shift to the next example. Please, dear student, concentrate first, okay? Then I will shift for the next example. Understood? 27 and 28, two examples we have done. And you please note down if you could not solve the example. Those students who could solve, just carry this and just check example, understand. Now, let us take number 29, okay? 29, I will solve for you. Understand? 30 is the example looking similar to that. So, that you will do in self-study, which we call SLP, self-learning practice. Understand? So, let me take number 29, okay? See, first question itself is clear. You just have to determine equivalent resistance, okay? And what they have given. Now you will grow confidence in this, I think. Understand? Now you will not find them so difficult because you have already come to know the importance of the junction point, means two electrodes, A and B. Here they have shown one resistor already, right? Then one resistor here. And then one resistor here. This is the example given to you. Understood? All the resistance has been given the value 4 ohm. This is again 4 ohm. And this is 8 ohm. I may call it R1. I may call this R2. And let us call this R3. Now, as you know extremely well, these two are the junction point. Here are the joints. But this is a constant wire without joint. So, these two are obviously said to be in series connection. So, I may call their equivalent resistance first as R4. Can I write this way? Let concentrate here, dear student. Let R4 be equivalent. These are some of the statements you need to write when you are asked it as an example. These statements are compulsory. Let R4 be equivalent resistance. Understand of R1 and R2 in series. Okay. So first the formula of series connection. R4 equals to R1 plus R2, 4 plus 4, 8 ohm. You understood this? Now the circuit has been reduced to this juncture. Understand? This is now the circuit. Right? And this is your resistance R4, which is 8 ohm. Now the rest of the part of the circuit can be needs to be eliminated because you already got the equivalent resistance for this too. Okay. So now you all know extremely well, it is looking like it is actually a parallel connection between which two resistor, R4 and R3, because when you come to the last stage of combination, you will take the equivalent resistance as R. You will write this way, let R be equivalent, okay, resistance of R3 and R4, okay, in parallel. Try to understand this. So write the formula for parallel connection, 1 upon R equal to 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4, 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 8, 2 upon 8 just cancel 1 upon 4 and R turns out to be 4 ohm, the equivalent resistance of the circuit. The example 29 which we have done. See the next example, example number 30 is looking the same like example number 29. You can solve example number 30 by yourself easily. In example number 30 only, you have to find equivalent resistance and at the same time also you have to find the current flowing in the circuit. So just R and one more step in that, and that is simply, what is that? As per Ohm's law, V equals to I into R. So that way you can solve. Understand? Is it clear? Right. Now, let us go for example 31. Okay. 31, I will do it for you. And 32 will be SLP for you, okay? So let us target example 31, okay? What is given in example 31? They have said, find electric current, that's by misprint it has been printed. Actually find equivalent resistance, understand, in the following circuit, okay? Let me draw circuit for you. Two junction point are already shown first. Point X and point Y, okay? And then they have shown the resistor in this way. One resistor, again one more resistor, okay. Here also in the same way, just try to look at the diagram because understanding diagram is very important. One more resistor here. Again, one more resistor. Okay. And in between, one more resistor here. They have just mentioned this as 3 ohm. This is 7 ohm, this is 10 ohm, okay. Here they have given 7 ohm and this is 3 ohm again. First, dear student, 31 I will solve it for you. 32 you can solve as per the design, okay. Now see, you have to find equivalent resistance between point X and Y, which are the target point actually, to electrodes between X and Y. So dear student, what I suggested the moment we started this lecture, whatever the 2 points which you get, you have to start from the distant resistance, understand? Now see dear student, just first concentrate on this part. I am just sectionalizing that part. You need to concentrate on this only. What it looks like, can you guess? No joints in this particular section. Both this resistor, if I may call them R1, this is R1. I may call it R2. I may call this R3. I may call this R4. I may call this R5. So these two resistors are already in series connection. So can I write this way? Let R6 be equivalent resistance of R1 and R2 in series. Okay, so let us first find R6 equal to R1 plus R2 3 plus 7, that is 10 ohm. Understood? Now the circuit has been reduced. These two resistors are already solved. Understand? So let us go like this way. Let me remove this part of the circuit. This is actually in exam, you do not have to do this, but that will enhance your confidence that this circuit, this section of the circuit has been reduced. Understand? Just to one common resistor now. Now this I can show this way. Understand? And then you join it. This is R6 already, which is 10 ohm. R1 and R2 has been reduced in this way. Now, can you guess now? R5 and R6 are already wire joints, see, in parallel connection. So let us do one thing. Let us take equivalent resistance of R5 and R6 as R7. Okay, let me write. Let R7 be equivalent resistance of R5 and R6, you need to mention in parallel. You understood this? So can I write this way? 1 upon R7 equal to 1 upon R5 plus 1 upon R6, 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 10, 2 upon 10, 1 upon 5, so R7 equal to 5 ohm. Circuit is yet more reduced. Now it just looking like this. Understand, the circuit is reduced yet, and this became now R7. Got it? This is R7, which is actually 5 ohm. Now anybody can guess. Last stage, all are in series connection. So when you come to the last stage, you all know, let R be equivalent resistance of R3, R4 and R7 in series. So the formula for the series connection, R3 plus R4 plus R7, it is 7 plus 5 plus 3. Understand, it is 15 ohm. See, dear student, this is the way. You can also solve numerical 32 in the similar manner. Okay, now see, dear student, as far as today's lecture is concerned, okay, I think rest of the example till 35 you can do. Understand? Yes, okay. So in today's lecture, what will be your homework? Though we have solved it here, but you will do it repeat. Understand? So you are going to solve example number 27 to 35 in today's lecture. That is your homework. Okay, dear student. Now there will be one more lecture for revising. In lecture number 6, we will complete the rest of the examples in PDF. Okay, thank you very much.